Respiratory support therapy continues to play a major role in helping patients suffering from COVID-19.
Medical reporter Dina Baer shows us how doctors are still finding innovative ways to help fight the virus.
While communities across the nation shift focus to racial injustice, inside hospitals, the mission to help those fighting COVID-19 continues. And those on the front lines of the healthcare crisis say they've mastered critical new techniques to help their patients. In the early days of the pandemic, the go-to device was the mechanical ventilator. There were fears of a shortage as doctors around the world witnessed COVID-19 patients decline quickly. But the intervention is risky.
We've known for a long time that when you put people on ventilators, the act of providing pressurized air into the lungs can actually cause some damage to the lungs. It's something called ventilator-associated lung injury. This was probably such a highly inflammatory condition that while it led to the need for a great amount of oxygen, actually putting them on ventilators probably precipitated even more damage to the lungs that were already in a fragile and inflamed state. And that probably led to higher mortality or very high mortality rates on ventilators. We were hearing rates of 75 to 80% once they got on ventilators.
That's when proning emerged as a strategy to help patients struggling to breathe. It takes a team to execute the complex maneuver.
And you can see that it's not simple, right? I mean, at the head of the bed is a respiratory therapist who has to secure the airway and the connection to the ventilator while they're actually flipping the patient over. And that usually requires about six nurses, three on each side, nurses and patient care technicians, to actually perform the physical act of proning.
The technique has been around long before COVID-19. It's most commonly used to help patients with lung disease improve blood oxygen levels. It works for those on and off a ventilator.
It's a complex physiology, but there seems to be something to do with stabilizing the chest wall and being able to recruit more lung volume that enables oxygen levels to improve.
DuPage Medical Group's Dr. Ravi Nemavant says patients can be placed in the proning position up to 16 hours a day, depending on how sick they are.
As a medical community, we have a much better approach to this illness now than we had 12 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. 12 weeks ago, it took us all by storm. It was dramatic and it was scary. And now we've learned so much about not just what works against the virus, what doesn't work against the virus, but we've learned a lot about our own capabilities to take care of these patients.
COVID-19 cases are down 20 to 25% in Dr. Nemavant's practice. And he says his patients who are able to tolerate proning appear to have better survival rates. Back to you.